Perfect, thank you.
If you really want enlightenment, then just lighten up.
Your question raising ability is not as strong as it could be. And when you start asking questions, you really understand your needs. You understand what it is that you want. And that's the first step to getting in the driver's seat and creating your reality the way that you want it.
So let's start with the energy of the year. All right. So from December 21st, 2012, up until the fall equinox in the Northern Hemisphere, September 22nd, 2013, you were basically in a gestation period in which you received more energy, the new, well, we'll call it vital energy, from the galactic center. You opened up to a greater alignment with this energy. And many of you have felt really, really stuck as a result of it, but really what you've been doing is adjusting to the new frequencies. It wasn't a time for action. It was a time for being still and a time for making small internal adjustments. You were moving from a state of doing back to a state of being and working from that space. So many of you felt a movement with this equinox into a bit more active state. It's slow going, but it's starting to pick up speed, that you feel clearer about what actions you need to take, what adjustments need to happen. And so that's part of the energy that you're moving into right now that will carry you through really the next 3 years. And then there will be probably another bit of a lull that you will go into, another deep clearing process. But for now, with November, there is a lot of potential for clearing out a lot of patterns. Now, how you all interpret this depends on whether you're heart-centered or whether you are in the mind, in the ego center. It can feel on the surface very, very challenging. And it will require you to be present. It will require you to be in your heart center.
Yeah, things are really running smoother.
Yep, seems so.
My friends over at Avatar Energy Institute are starting to get ready to get out there and get more people interested. I told them
they're done fighting.
Well, they're still thinking, like the one was thinking that he has to get an okay, and I told him, no, you just decide what you need to do and you do it. And everyone else will do what they decide or need to do to express themselves, and they'll do that. And you may get together and have conversations which may produce inspiration for you to expand further in one direction or another, but it's up to you to deal with your own expansion, and you give you permission to do whatever you do. No one else does. And
if you read the links that I gave you,
yeah,
you'll see that that's following the same sort of rising awareness.
Mm-hmm. But that's what it's about today, is realize that you don't have to group together and all do the same thing. You can do different things.
Yeah.
As different expressions of the same thing. And still,
it doesn't even mean you don't have to group together. It's
right,
just
right.
When you group together, stop trying to be the same cog in the wheel.
Right.
Allow yourselves to be different cogs in a wheel.
Right. In other words, the harmony is created when you all decide to be yourselves, and it'll just naturally work itself in. And you don't need permission from one person or another to do this or do that. You need to give yourself permission to do it and just do it.
Yeah, exactly.
And these are for people that can do some telekinesis and other things, get their backwards on the philosophical and the metaphysical concepts. Because I told them, nothing actually exists outside of yourself. those are just projections that become mirrors.
Yeah, listen to the kid who was talking to Neo.
Uh-huh.
The truth is that there is no spoon.
Mm-hmm.
You are only bending yourself.
Right. And I was also going with Picard's favorite saying, it's not, circumstances don't matter, only state of being matter.
Because it's all a projection.
Yeah, things are beginning to get closer to the surface of the consciousness, of normal consciousness. It's like super consciousness is expanding in, just underneath the layer of consciousness now. And it pops through at different points.
You got it. I text.
Yeah, and I mean, my dad's ego is also having a bit of a hard time because he's starting to see that it's mostly the older people that have gotten dumb and stupid and are believing bullshit. Mm-hmm. The younger people are the smarter, more awake and aware. He always used to think it was reversed. He thought, you know, younger people are dumb because they're dumb and they haven't learned yet. They're young and young, dumb, and full of cum, as Dad likes to say. And, you know, he's just thinking age, you know, youth equals stupid and age equals wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
I told him a long time ago that's complete horseshit. I mean, that he'll find it out one day, that it's inevitable that he'll find out that it's horseshit.
Mm-hmm. Tyler Davenport.
Yes. Yeah. Because, you know, I told him, just wait, you'll find it. Yeah, whatever. And now he's forced to see it. He's forced to admit it. Like, holy shit. You know, he's seeing that it's people in their teens, 20s, and 30s going around going, hey, you know, wake up. And he's seeing that it's mostly people who are in their 40s, 50s, 60s, and 70s going, oh, that's bullshit. But one thing that he does kind of have on his side, interestingly enough, the fact that he is a veteran, he can say to some dumb idiot who's in their 40s, 50s, or 60s, hey, look, asshole, I'm a veteran, I've seen shit you haven't, so you're a fucking idiot, and you can't say you've seen what I've seen. You can't say that you know what I know, you can't say you know better, I've seen shit you'll fucking never know.
Oh,
it's a real bitch for them to dispute that, unless he's talking to another vet.
Yeah, they do act that way, though, don't they? Of course, then again, you can go with Bonnie's method of getting extra people to his radio station, so who does he pick? Tyler.
Yeah. Michelle needs a bit of a break from my energy. She was saying before she wanted to talk and stuff tonight, but I already knew the energies weren't aligned with it. So I was just focusing my energy on just kind of the idea of her standing in her sovereignty and whatever she wants to do or not is fine, just, you know, be in alignment with herself. And she said, I actually do not want to talk tonight, ha ha ha. I'm sorry, but there's always another day to look forward to, and that's awesome. I said, yes, it is, and yes, you are. Have an awesome night, my awesome friend. And what I also feel is that's kind of a test. She wants to talk, but she's willing to not talk just to feel appreciated by the fact that I was just like, okay, no problem, and didn't try to fight with her on it or force my will or anything. Just to kind of see me go, okay, no problem. Catch you another time. Because she's not used to it being that easy.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's one of the main reasons she doesn't want to talk tonight, just so she could see it be that easy.
Well, that's what I've been doing lately, too, is I notice I check with my energy before I answer. I mean, I've had 3 calls today from the all avatars and group calls. And each time the call was coming in, I checked my energy and if I wanted to talk or not, if I felt I had the energy and felt right with the talk.
Yeah.
Before I even did it. In fact, I actually turned down a call yesterday. Of course, that had BTR on it.
Mm. Well, you and I are so in alignment that I don't even call when you don't want to talk to me.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like we're even in alignment as far as not being in alignment when we're supposed to not be in alignment.
Mm-hmm.
So when you're not in the mood to deal with me, you notice that by default, I don't show up.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just not there. I'm nowhere to be found. I'm gone. Just automatically. You didn't have to do anything. Because that's just how it works when we let it.
Mm-hmm.
when we allow for alignments to maintain themselves and not micromanage the fuck out of every little goddamn thing.
Well, that's what I've been doing now is, you know, I check my energy now.
Oh, I've been doing that a lot with a lot of things and trying to get more practice with acting on my energetics before anything. Because what I was doing before, kind of like training myself, is like, you know, because the idea of when you do things differently and deviate from normal patterns and you shift your energies, then it has different effects. And, you know, you don't want to stay stuck in the rut of saying this.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I was doing that for a while, but I've stopped doing that because I've noticed that doing that too much actually perpetuates another form of sameness. The sameness of, oh, well, I need to do that in order to shift the energy. So then that actually starts to create a stagnancy. So I thought to myself, what's really the easiest way to create a shift? And the answer came back, simple. Just do what you never do. And I'm like, I thought to myself, okay, what is it that I never do? Or shall we say that I don't give myself permission to as much, you know, that it's not a default reflex. What should be a default reflex that isn't? Simple. Align with my joy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, don't base anything on, well, to do this, do that, da-da-da, you know.
But in other words,
the trap that Bashar outlined.
All right.
If I do this, then, if then.
Oh,
you're still in the same trap. Remember what he said about that?
Well, it's more of a matter of if the alignment will bring you joy at this moment, or is there other things that you should be doing instead that would bring you more?
Yeah, exactly my point. That's how I was going back to what Bashar was saying.
And to do that, you got to deal with the body, the energetic,
yeah,
of what you're at, the state you're in at that moment, to what if you should do it or not. And
exactly. And that's exactly what I was doing. I was just like, all right, well, I need to go with energetics. So I asked myself, what's in my highest joy right now? And in being fully honest with myself, the initial answer I get is, well, I don't know. Then I ask myself, what does my highest joy feel like? And then I resonate that frequency. And as soon as I build up that frequency, all of a sudden I know exactly what I need to go through.
Mm-hmm. But that's what I've been doing lately as well.
Because it's like resonating the frequency. You know, even like I said on a Paradigm Shift episode, I think it was, God, 2011, it might have been 2012, I think it was 2011, I said that the frequency is like typing in the web address.
Oh, this conversation we're having right now, you want the MP3 for it?
Not when it's done.
Okay.
But it's like, you know, it's like typing in the web address.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I had, you know, I totally went into that. As a matter of fact, see if I can find that right quick.
How in the fuck am I supposed to resonate that? I'm looking to obtain it. I don't have it. If I had it, then I wouldn't need to be making the little request for it.
Yeah, and that was in 2011, May 18.
Something that I need.
Can you hear it okay?
Yeah.
Pay attention. You like something. There's a specific energetic state here. There's a feeling. Going to the most minute detail. Have you noticed I'm very, very, very light? Can you cross the window there? This is very, very, very good feeling. When you might like, say, chocolate ice cream, and both of those are very, very good feeling. When you might like, oh, I don't know, a 2011 Lamborghini Miata. Even just the thought of liking something is resonating frequency. You don't have to already possess it. I mean, you can just be of the opinion that you like it, even if you don't get it. I mean, you know, how many of you people out there
you're sending a content request to the server.
And when you navigate on that, you want to go and type yahoo.com, right? Well, if you type yahoo.com instead of com, you make a typo, you get that one little text, and you're going to get an error 404, 8.8, whatever. It's not really what you're looking for. But the other thing is, the filter, you're not going to manifest what you're looking for. Worst case, like the freaking internet. So pay attention. Make sure you got the metaphysical web address right. Pay attention to how you're feeling. That's the web address. Everybody's feeling it. Feeling, your emotions let you know what the hell you're thinking. So pay attention to that, because you know what you're thinking, how you're feeling, your surroundings, what's going on, because in all this at the same time, you can feel and grab up that metaphysical web address, put it into the quantum browser, and make the request for the server, and then look what we did instead of sitting there pushing the phone and going, I don't know, how are you supposed to load up a website if you don't have loaded up already? Put the fucking address in the browser, thank you, and make sure it's not your street address.
Make sure it's not your street address. We used to make that joke about people who use AOL. Mm-hmm. These people are so stupid, it's asking for an address, or type it in their street address, going, what the hell? Wouldn't be surprised if there's some people who've actually done that. I think everybody knows what an address bar is now these days, that people aren't doing that anymore. But I mean, you know, in the not-too-distant past, when computers weren't, like, everywhere, everything, you know, integrated into everything, including wristwatches, cell phones, and every other damn thing. It was a good address bar. You know.
Yeah.
It's like there's some people that used to think that the CD tray is a cup holder. They call tech support bitching that their cup holder broke. The cup holder, what? And they are press any key to continue. Ooh, where's the any key? I actually heard it's either Hewlett Packard or Packard Bell or somebody like. They got so many freaking calls about, where's the any key? That for a while on their keyboards, they actually had to include a key that had the word any in order to get those calls to stop. I mean, I think most people are at a high enough consciousness now that they're not quite that bad, because, you know, most people are used to the whole idea of at least basically how computers work, but man, before that, it wasn't too long ago, was it? I mean, look at how quickly we've evolved, even in the last 10 years. I mean, hell, in the last, you know, 100 years or so, we've gone from, like, horse and buggy to, like, a full-blown technological society. So, I mean, it's just, you know, advancements keep, you know, escalating.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll just keep escalating.
Yeah, we sure went through a lot of changes very quickly. And the changes are getting quicker and quicker.
Yeah, seems easier to manage then. So it's definitely been a wild ride. Oh, and even recently, you know, the Google Hangout that, you know, I had with Katarina?
Yeah.
There's already other YouTube channels that have been, you know, like, uploading it to their channel. I posted it on Katarina's group on Facebook, Be You to the Fullest. I said, Katarina, people are already starting to add this to their channels. This is a copy on a channel called S News for All. That's the letter S, the word news, the number four, the word all. And so somebody else already grabbed it. Well, at least it's not Dear Shit Native Morons this time. I know people have been starting to, like, grab that one from my other channel.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of perpetuated out. Remember that?
Yeah.
Oh, and I posted a link to my Paradigm Shift on Educational Comedy page in Katarina's Facebook group, and it says, if you have any sanity left, then no worries. You can be rid of the rest of it by visiting this page. Now that Skype recorder is working for you again, I wonder if it'll start working for me again, too. Maybe it's just some sort of weird glitch in that.
Well, what I did,
What'd you do?
I downloaded our earlier version of Skype.
Oh.
In fact, after December, it's not going along, no longer work because they're changing the format on Skype, so it won't.
Really?
Well, that's what it says when it loads.
Like, they're intentionally changing the format to get the recorder to not work?
Skype's changing. You know, Microsoft.
Yeah, I know, but I'm just saying, is that the intention for the change? Does it state that outright, or... Or are they just saying that the recorder won't work until we compensate for it again? Or are they trying to say that Microsoft is doing it on purpose to be able to fuck over the recorder?
Well, what they say is that they're doing it to, they're changing the software to cross-platform across a number of devices, like, phones and stuff.
Ah, okay. So that more things are supported, so that the NSA can spy on more things.
Right. So they can spy on your ass without having to work their ass off to do it. What it amounts to.
So they're going to make Skype able to be installed on a suppository? That's a neat trick.
Hmm. I thought it was a suppository already.
Your ass.
Not my ass.
Oh, anybody's ass. The new Skype version can now install to your ass. Start this suppository. The NSA can regulate your digestive system. It's the new way to be chipped by the Illuminati. Just stick Skype up your ass. There we go. Our new nanotechnology will merge with your rectum. No need to wait for the FEMA troops to show up at your door. You can get surprise butt sex 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, just by sticking Skype up your ass. There we go.
Yeah, they're just trying to rectify their software, that's all.
Yeah, rectify the audio quality there. Can you hear me now? Good.
New form of reconciliation, huh? But sex without pets.
Without the bear. I think the pedo bear image was like made based off of Sugar Bear. Mm-hmm. Remember those commercials for Sugar Bear?
Yeah.
I think that was for Golden Crisp or whatever the hell that cereal was.
Sugar Smack.
I barely remember the commercial. And the bear with the deep voice that hummed that little tune.
At least we're automatically checking now. You know, I do it because it's second nature now, you know, to check everything like that by frequency.
Now, when it's first nature, so that we don't even have to check, then we're getting somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Not quite there yet, though. Rome was not built in a day.
Well, it doesn't matter. You have to be a saint. Such a habit of doing it that it just does it naturally.
Neural networks. Fun neural networks.
Alright. It just hasn't gotten that complex yet. It's working its way that way, though.
Yeah. Technically, it takes about 30 days to create a neural network, but the thing is, with this sort of stuff, it's more than one neural network. There's a lot of deprogramming and reprogramming of oneself to be able to do that, because it's not just based around one particular idea, one particular neural network. There's just a lot of shit we're clearing out, a lot of bad habits, necessarily even bad in the moral standpoint. bad in the sense of counterproductive. They're just fun with a capital F-U. It's haven't really been so wonderful for us as a human species. They kind of suck. We're just kind of taking out the garbage. Little by little. We're all getting used to what we haven't been used to. That our egos would say, no, that's not possible. Misery's the only real reality. We gotta pay our torture tax. Meow, meow, meow. My YouTube views keep climbing quicker and quicker. I'm already up to over 1,300,000 views. And I got these two videos. Katarina's in both of them, actually. These two videos, they almost seem to be, like, in competition with each other as far as, like, views. When I go in and look at the rankings as far as, like, most popular and shit.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see, what were these up to? Just want to jump in here so I can have it in front of me. Yeah, PSEC 2013, Regular People Making a Difference, and PSEC 2013, Katarina Edwards and Peel Scott, Letting Go of Guilt and Self-Abuse. The first one is at 147,297. Second one's at 147,265. So they're, like, real close. It's like they're neck and neck, like it's a horse race. Mm-hmm. Yeah, me and Katarina in the near future are supposed to be doing a little paradigm shift educational comedy Google Hangout sort of thing as far as how to do stuff on YouTube, so that should be interesting. That's something I've been wanting to do for a while. I'll let you know when that's happening. Because I don't even know yet. Kind of just playing it, might you? Yeah.
Actually, checking with yourself like that automatically is a pretty good jump, really. Last month I wouldn't even thought about it, I'd have just answered. You touched on the exhaustion, so to speak.